Folks, Dagan here from PMT the UK, and this joyous thing is the Ibanez Jem Jr in fluorescent pink. And what a fantastic guitar this is. It's just remarkable, isn't it? Look at it. It delivers on tone, feel, and it looks a million bucks. This thing is awesome. Firstly, a little disclaimer in this video though. Apologies, I am not actually Steve Vai. I haven't got his massive American digits. I'm graced with what God gave me, and I haven't got years of talent behind me. So if you guys want to hear lots of Steve Vai riffs, or you want to play some Steve Vai riffs, you've got to rock up to a PMT store yourself and try one of these Jem Juniors out, because they're kick-ass and they deliver on all the Steve Vai tones. I'm just not going to get done for copyright in this video. So firstly, I'm going to talk you through the specs and a little bit of history on the Ibanez Jem, and then show you what it sounds like. I'm using two Atec cables into a Daddario pedal chromatic tuner, into the Blackstar HT Stage 100 watt Mark II head and cab. I'm not micing it up though, you guys are hearing it through a two notes Torpedo Captor X, which is emulating a Blackstar cab, into a Zoom thing, and then into your lovely ears. That's enough about that. Let's talk about this. So, the Ibanez Jem. Ibanez Jem is actually the best-selling signature guitar of all time. I mean, technically the Les Paul is, because it's Les Paul Gibson, but besides the Les Paul, which is kind of just a model, the Ibanez Jem is the best-selling signature guitar of all time. And that's not surprising. Obviously, not everyone is a huge Steve Vai fan, but these are some of the most versatile, well-built guitars on the planet, whether you're paying crazy money for the 7V or even the Jem Juniors. The Jem first came about in 1987, the Jem 777s, what they were called. There was a neon green one, a neon yellow one, and a neon pink one. Those are years before the white ones we all know today, like the Evo and the Flow, what Steve plays now. The first ones were crazy colors, and then brought them back for the Jem Juniors. They're not a lot of money, and they deliver on that epic 80s feel and vibe. I'm very much of the ilk of guitar playing is very much in the head of the player. And when you look down and see this guitar, or you see yourself in reflections, because it glows. It actually glows, like everything's pink around you when you play this guitar. It makes you feel a certain way and play all the best music from the 80s. So there are three colors available on the Jem Jr. The fluorescent pink, the yellow, and the standard white one. I say standard, like I said, it's the one everyone's probably more accustomed with when it comes to Mr. Steve Vai. And I'm so pleased they brought these out, because original versions from the 87 are many, many thousands of pounds. And this is the best way to get that vibe for not a lot of money. These are super cheap guitars. I've got a 7V myself. I love it to bits. I'm not gonna lie, this isn't far off. Obviously the specs are quite different, but throw some Damasios in this, put a Edge double locking trem on, and you're pretty much 90% of the way there. So the Jem Jr. in any color is a great guitar for the Steve Vai fan that doesn't wanna spend lots of money, for the guy that wants a super versatile guitar with the HSH configuration, all the single coil tones and a double locking tremolo, or for the guy or gal that wants to stand out from the crowd with a neon pink Ibanez guitar with a monkey grip in it. So the specs on this bad lad, Maranti body, and it's carved exactly the same way as the Jem. So it's got the monkey grip with a little carve at the back there, super easy access to that 24th jumbo fret. Yeah, full 2-octave range, 24 frets, and the input jack goes in at the top like that, so not through the bottom, so when you stand on your cable, which happens all the time, it doesn't pull out the guitar and you haven't got to loop it around your strap. Such a cool little feature. It's also got the little, what are they called, ferrules, I think they're called, behind the tram here. It's cool, and like I keep saying, it's exactly the same as a fully fledged, full fat Ibanez Jem. It's badass. Maple neck, and it's a Wizard 3 profile, which is slightly different to a Jem neck. Jems are thinner than this, but not to everyone's taste. I see a lot of Vai fans who finally come in and go, oh, can I play that £2,500 7V? Of course you can, rock it. The neck's too thin. So that, I think this neck is more accustomed to the regular player that wants to play a few different genres, but still have the same Steve Vai vibe, if that kind of makes sense. It's just not as paper thin. Headstock as well, also painted with the lovely fluorescent pink. All the hardware is that lovely smoked chrome that Ibanez use on everything. It's awesome. Going down the fingerboard, you will see the Tree of Life, the classic Steve Vai signature Tree of Life inlay on this Jatoba fingerboard, and it's a lovely flat fingerboard as well. Perfect for getting your shred on. Like I said, 24 jumbo frets, and a little bit of nerdy Ibanez Jem history here. I'm so pleased they didn't do a maple neck. These guitars originally had maple necks back in 1987, but the really rare ones were the Jem 777s SVK, I believe, and they had Tree of Lives on. So this is like an even rarer variant for the Ibanez Jem Jr. It's just a cool little bit of nerdy fact. Pink pickups as well, so the HSH configuration. These aren't Damasios, these are Ibanez's whack at the Damasio, made in-house, a bit cheaper, hence the price. Two humbuckers, pink like the original, with a five-way switch. So the single coil in the middle can be activated, or you can blend it in with the inner coils of the neck or bridge humbucker. One volume, one tone, and that double locking Ibanez tremolo like I was talking about before. This is more like a licensed Floyd Rose as opposed to the Ibanez Edges. Just two different ways of making things. One's not necessarily better than the other. It's just slightly different. And I think that's all the specs. Let's do this some more. I did say I wasn't going to play any Steve Vai, so sorry, Steve, if you're watching. Do you want to learn a quick Steve Vai lick? One of my favorite things to play. It's really easy and you sound like Steve Vai. Fifth fret on the low E string, gonna be on the neck pickup. And the seventh fret on the A string. The power chord kind of thing. And just repeat that up the strings, but slide up. So 5-7. Go from 5 to 7 on the A string. So then you're on 7-9. The same shape, so you basically just go with a little slide in between. Play it fast, you sound like Steve Vai. Anyways, back to the guitar. So the bridge pickup has got a lot of bite and a lot of poke. The neck pickup is beautiful and creamy. Perfect for when you want to go. Shh, don't tell Steve. Some clean sounds in a second, but I just want to show you how well these pickups clean up, because they are high output pickups when you roll the volume down on your guitar. So this is position 4, the inner coil of the neck pickup and that single coil from the middle. Thank you. That sounds very kind of country rock. That's the inner coil, well, position two, the inner coil of the bridge humbucker and the single coil in the middle. That tone's a far cry from Passion and Warfare, but you can do everything with a gem. Upper access to the higher frets is just second to none on a gem. Let's hear some clean tones now. That lovely neck pickup. The bridge pickup is quite hot. I wasn't expecting that. Great sounding guitar though, isn't it? Again, it's just that tender surrender tone. While I'm playing of that. But it does dirty up a bit, it just shows how much output this bridge pickup has. And it just screams at you. Stays in tune great. Right, that's enough of that. This was a lot of fun. I love Steve Vai and the Ibanez Jem Juniors. For the price, there's nothing better. To have on the wall and smile, to play and smile, to see people's minds be blown in the crowd, which in turn makes you smile, I think it's fantastic and you've got to check one out. Let me know down below in the comments what you think of these majestic guitars and what colour you would buy. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMT UK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on the Ibanez Jem Jr or any Ibanez for that matter, get your fine self to pmtonline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these with nice filters on. I've been Dagan and I'll see you next time.